Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good evening, good morning, good afternoon, depending on your time zone. Welcome to Savik TV, your home of infotainment. For the new subscribers, you are the right place. For the returning subscribers, thank you so much. Welcome back. And thanks for always supporting Savik TV. So basically, guys, we are here to do a review. We are post-Christmas, right? Today is the 28th of December 2023. So how was Christmas, ladies and gentlemen? How did it go? How was your Christmas celebration? How did it go? Did you celebrate well? Did you enjoy eating whatever you are eating? Did you have fun? You know, I know I have a couple of I have a lot of subscribers who probably didn't celebrate Christmas. My Muslim fraternity, not just my Muslim fraternity, there are even SDAs and all that really don't celebrate Christmas as such. But still, I believe that you all got a chance to take a break, you know, from the hustle and bustles of life to just, you know, have a feel of that Christmas break. So I believe that all in the spirit of Christmas, we had a good break. We enjoyed the Christian families, Christian fraternity, or Christian neighbors who are celebrating Christmas actually got to invite us to celebrate with them, right? Did they invite you? If they didn't invite you, please don't invite them during Ramadan. But anyway, basically, I believe that you all had fun. And yeah, it's back to work. It's a back to work season. We're on the 28th. People are back to work. Business is back as usual. We are all now waiting for the new year, that is on first, next Monday, to now start the year in style. So the purpose of this video this afternoon or this evening, I'm saying this evening because it's about it's 5 p.m. it's 12 minutes past 5 p.m. in Kenya, so it's evening basically. The main purpose of this video is to just take stock of how has the year been. I believe that we all had our aspirations, we had our resolutions for the year, we had plans for 2023. So how many, what percentage of your plans have you actually achieved? I believe we all had different plans. You're like, you know, I'm gonna do this. How much have you achieved, bro, out of everything that you had actually purposed to do? You know, how much have you actually achieved? And if you haven't achieved, what actually happened? What has made you not achieve what you'd actually planned to achieve? I believe, you know, when the year starts, a lot of people normally say, I'm gonna cut weight. Losing weight is always the first agenda or the first resolution, because we are from Christmas, we've eaten, we've put on a lot of weight. So when the year is starting, we are like, you know what, I'm gonna lose weight. So that is the first resolution. You come out, you wanna lose weight, you hit the gym the first month, and then you're like, ah, damn, man, I'm not gonna do this again. I'm not gonna do this anymore. So you opt out of the gym. That is what most people do. Please don't do that. But if you had actually planned to lose weight, did you manage to do that? Did you manage to lose weight? If you didn't, what made you not do it? And what are you planning to do differently in the new year? So that is the first thing. A lot of people normally plan to lose weight. Secondly, I believe that when 2023 was starting, a lot of people were like, you know, I'm gonna enroll for maybe a given course in college or university. I'm gonna further my education, right? You know, personal empowerment, personal growth, that is what everybody always wants to do. So did you do it? If you had purpose to do to work on your personal growth, did you achieve it? Did you? I'm asking you. Did you achieve your personal growth? If you didn't achieve, what made you not achieve your personal growth, ladies and gentlemen? Don't worry, I'm just hanging at the rooftop of where I stay. So that's why I'm actually taking, it's a cool evening, so I'm just taking this breeze right there. So did you achieve it? You wanted to further your education. Did you achieve it? If you didn't, what actually made you not achieve what you had purposed to do? And what are you planning to do to ensure that you get to achieve what you had planned to achieve in 2023 and you actually failed to do it. So that is the second thing. Personal growth. You know, some kids are making noise here, so I'm trying to send them away. Don't worry. Yeah, man, you know the kids police with YouTube, so I'm trying my level best to ensure that they are not in the frame. Now, personal growth, you've talked about going to the gym. Which other thing did you really want to do? Build a house, maybe buy land, do some, you know, grow some assets and all. A lot of people normally do have such plans. You know, I'm gonna buy land. I'm gonna, you know, that is what I wanna do. I wanna buy land. I wanna build, you know. So, did you purpose to buy land? And if you had purpose to buy land, did you actually do it? Did you achieve it? Did you buy the land that you had actually purposed to do? If yes, were you able to construct a house, or you are the team that says, you know, I'll rather sleep in the car than travel in a house, because ideally the house cannot move, but the car can move. So your priorities are, I'll rather buy a car first, then, you know, buildings will follow later, right? So, what had you purpose to do this year? Was it to buy a house? Was it to build a house? Was it to buy land? You know, basically investment. That is what most people always purpose to do when the year starts. I want to start a business. Were you able to do that? You know, I'm asking all these questions. I expect you guys to actually respond to them in the comment section. Another thing that we need to respond to as well, a lot of people normally start saving up, you know. You come up with the things they call the 52-week plan, the 52-week savings plan. So you come up with such plans, very nice plans about how you're going to save. And now, my question is, at the end of the day, do you actually end up saving, or is it just a plan, or does it just remain in the books as a plan? Because a lot of people, don't mind the background, this is where we air our clothes. As I said, I'm on the rooftop, so I was just changing the location so that I can give you some background. Now, a lot of people are like, I am gonna save, you know, I mean, I'm saving a 52-week savings plan. So from the first day of the year, I'm starting to save. I'll be saving this much. So were you able to achieve that? You had your savings plan, you had your what you wanted to do. Were you able to do it? We are taking stock, ladies and gentlemen, for those who are just joining this video at this point. So we are taking stock of what we've been able to achieve in 2023. You had your resolutions at the beginning of the year. We are about 3 days left to close the year. So we are just taking stock. How much, or to what extent, of the resolutions that you had put in place at the beginning of the year, to what extent have you achieved them? Is it 100%? Is it zero? Because again, if you had said you want to lose weight, you are weighing 90 at the beginning of the year, you hit the gym for 2 days and you drop, you are now weighing 95, then that means automatically it's a zero as far as achievement of your goals or your resolution is concerned. As far as that weight resolution is concerned, it's a zero. Yeah, you had said maybe I'll buy land somewhere, I'll invest. Up to this point, there is no investment you've done, and maybe there was no, you know, sometimes there can be challenges. Maybe someone got sick, you had to pay school fees for someone, some emergencies came up. But in a case where no emergencies actually came up and you just blew the money, you know, you have yourself to blame. But basically, we're just doing a self-assessment. So, whichever question I'm actually asking you guys is not meant for you alone. It's a question that I'm equally asking myself as a thing. Okay, Savik, you'd targeted to do this at the beginning of the year. I was weighing 98 kgs at the beginning of the year. I'm weighing 88 now. I've shed a bit, not so much, but at least I've shed 10 kgs. So, for me, I feel like, as far as weight loss is concerned, again, because I joined the gym and I've been very consistent throughout the year. So, I guess for one, man, at least I did that. Investment, not really. I tried, but not really. I didn't achieve as much as I had expected. Buying myself a car, it was one of the resolutions of the year. Unfortunately, I didn't manage to do that. Maybe I will. Maybe I will, but you know, we keep trying. We live to try another day, right? So, I live to try another day again. So we keep trying. We try every other time. Sometimes things work, sometimes things fail to work. But you know, you should never give up. John Cena says that every other time, never give up. So, my guys, never give up at any particular time. So anytime you feel like giving up, just don't give up. Basically, the life that you're actually living right now, there's someone wishing to be where you are. So sometimes you may really be uneasy about the match you've achieved. So you're like, man, I wish I could be driving. Someone wishes to be walking. He's on a wheelchair. He's like, man, I wish I was able to walk like this guy. So you want new shoes. Someone is walking barefooted, barefoot, you know. They're like, I wish I had shoes. The shoes that you don't like, the shoes that you don't appreciate, someone else out there feels like, I wish I had such, you know. So there's someone who actually envies your life. There's someone who actually wishes they were in your feet or in your shoes, you know. So let's always be grateful. But again, as I said, it's a challenge to everyone. Whoever is watching Savit right now, we all had our resolutions. How much of our resolutions have you guys achieved? You had planned to do whatever. How far have you gone with it? That aside, as I finish this video, I had promised myself to do a very, very brief or short video. So, at this point, I get to question you guys. Not question really, but challenge you guys. 2 days, perhaps 3 days from now, we'll be in the new year, right? We will be in the new year, and you know, everyone will be out here making resolutions for the new year. So you'll be here committing and challenging yourself. You know, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna do 1, 2, 3. You know. So, back in school, not in school actually, even the school of life, you should always set SMART goals. SMART is an acronym, right? So you should always set SMART goals. These goals that you're setting actually should be very specific. They should be measurable. You know, they should be achievable goals, right? SMART. What else? Have I forgotten? They should be time bound. I forgot to know what the R means, but basically it should be SMART goals, right? So you should always set very SMART goals. Let's not just go into the new year 2024 blindly. That yes, I'm setting resolutions, I'm setting targets, but blindly. Let's set SMART goals in the sense that if I'm saying I wanna invest, what kind of investment do I wanna go into? And in this particular investment that I wanna go into, how much does it require? So if it requires, let's say, 1 million shillings, how am I going to raise 1 million Kenyan shillings? How am I going to raise that 1 million naira? You know, the moment you break it down that way, then you now say, okay, I'll be saving this much monthly. This is the much I'll secure from the bank as a loan. Such like, and then that is how you'll get to land at, you know, the investment that you wanna get into. The same applies to any other goal. If it's you wanna lose weight, what am I weighing? How much do I wanna lose? How many days do I need to be training for me to achieve this? What is the new meal plan that I need to adopt to get to this? You know, so all this. Do I need a diet change? I wanna get married. You can't have a resolution to get married when you don't even have a girlfriend in the first place. So you first need to start dating, right? You have to start dating, identify the girl, date her, and then once you've dated her, you can now, you know, maybe get engaged to her, and then after that you can say, nah, at the end of this year I'll get married, because at least you have your plan, right? So let's have a plan. Let's set goals. The goal should be very SMART, and that is the only way we can achieve our resolutions come 2024, because 2023 honestly is gone. We have 3 days to go. So in 3 days, I don't believe that can say I'm gonna achieve much of what I was unable to achieve for the entire over 361 days of the year. So you can't just save 362 days in 3 days, right? Let's just say, let bygones be bygones, right? Yes, of course, guys. And then we focus on the future. So basically that will be it, ladies and gentlemen. It was a very short video. The main thing is taking stock of 2023. How was Christmas? How far have you achieved as far as your resolutions are concerned? What do we have in store for the new year? So we'll keep challenging each other going forward, so that come end of 2024, we'll be out here taking stock and saying, you know what? We challenged ourselves last year, and surely we've done it. Of course, through God, and God is the one who strengthens us, or the higher being. You know, people believe in different higher beings, so the higher power has made us achieve what we had actually planned to achieve. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching Savik TV. I've never done such videos. It's like the first time I'm trying an outdoor video of just talking to you guys without moving around and everything. I do hope that you like the video, and if you like such kind of content, please let me know so that I plug you with such going forward, alongside the vlogs that we do from time to time. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and let me say bye for now. Peace out. Bye bye. Happy New Year.